Welcome to Any Way You Slice It, where we talk about your identity and purpose in the kingdom of God. Come join author Ricardo Richardson as we slice our way to the core of God's Word to experience the beautiful and transformational discovery of who we are and why we exist, no matter how we slice it.
Today's message is Test to Bless. Beloved family, our text says, "See, I have refined you, though not as silver. I have tested you in the furnace of affliction. For my own sake, I do this. How can I let myself be defamed? I will not yield my glory to another." Isaiah 40:10-11. I remember growing up in the Bahamas, we played outside till the lights came on. Basketball was played on the rimmed bicycle hoop nailed to the lamppost. We played baseball, or bat and ball, as we called it. And one of my favorite games was called porking. That's another word for dodgeball. But when darkness fell and the lights came on, we had to go inside. Those were different times back then, where if you did something wrong or misbehave in school or in the neighborhood, you didn't have to wait to get home to get disciplined. Everyone had the right to discipline you because they did it out of love. Today is different. Parents don't discipline or disciple their children because the children have too much authority. They believe that spanking or beating or even scolding and punishment is abusive. In fact, we should just sit and have a rational, intelligent conversation with our children, they say. There's no right or wrong. There's no boundaries, no real rules to follow. We give them so much freedom and authority, then we wonder why kids can't handle the pressures of life today. And most are depressed and can't really function as we did growing up. They haven't been toughened by us, so they are left exposed to the world to abuse them. I remember my mom would tell me, "Hard work never killed anybody," or "What doesn't kill you will make you stronger." And those two nuggets of discipline has grounded me throughout my life. I've been through some hard situations, but I'm still standing. God kept me through it all, and it has made me stronger, not my own strength, but in my faith. This reminds me of how Jonah disobeyed God and went in another direction, defiant against God. The Lord disciplined him by sending a strong storm to disrupt what he wanted to do. But the storm was not only for Jonah. It was for the sailors on the ship as well. As a result of Jonah being in that place, they all recognized that the one true God is the God of Jonah, and they vowed to serve him that day. That's the thing when we discipline our children or our parents disciplined us. It was usually just for us. But when God disciplines us, it's for everyone. It makes us better and makes the kingdom better. Because we don't discipline our children today as we were disciplined, it's one of the reasons we believe God should change the way he disciplines or disciples us. See, God's discipline is not by word only, but by testing and correction. I like the New King James translation of Proverbs 12:6. "For whom the Lord loves, he chastens and scourges every son whom he receives." When God receives us as his son, he's doing so like the prodigal son. To be received is to come back home to our father. But he scourges us when we are in disobedience. That word scourge literally and figuratively means to flog. And to flog means to beat with a whip to punish. "Wait, God beats us? I thought God was a God of love," they say. Yes, but he is a God who chastises and disciplines. We have to stop buying into all the schemes of the enemy. Every word of God, Satan turns upside down. God says discipline. Satan says compromise and negotiate. God says honor your mother and father. Satan says be disrespectful to your parents. God says seek first the kingdom. Satan says seek first the riches of the world. God only wants us to continue to look and act like him. He does this for our good and his name's sake. If we are his children, we must have his image and likeness. He is holy, so we must be. He is love, so we must be. He is faithful, so we must be. What child you know has no resemblance of their father? And the text again says, "For my own sake, I test you. How can I let myself be defamed? I will not yield my glory to another." God tests you to set you up to bless you. And you thought this testing, trouble, and discipline is all about you. No, it's all about God. His name is on the line, and he won't give his glory to another. Much love.